So you're on YouTube and you're making YouTube videos. And what do you want? You want views. You want those views to go up, 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 and up. And you get super excited when they go up. And when it suddenly drops and dies, you're like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna go so much into a depression. And you're wondering why? Why does this all happen? Why is this going on? Well, in this video, I'm gonna share with you 5 reasons why your videos suddenly drop. But more importantly, at the end of the video, I'm gonna tell you actually how to fix it. Now, I've been on YouTube since 2005, and I actually own an agency where we work with some of the top brands and businesses and YouTube creators on the planet. And I love my job. And I can tell you that every time that there's a shift in the algorithm or something that's actually going on, I get a phone call, a DM, personal message, and I get a whole bunch of emails asking why is my channel actually dying here? Does YouTube hate me? Do YouTube like want to punish me? Why is this actually happening? Well, this video is going to answer the why, and we're starting right now. Now, the first reason why: viewer behavior and seasonal trends. Now, let's kind of deep dive into this. Every viewer comes to YouTube for a specific reason, and there's certain things that are more attractive to them to click on because of things that are seasonally going on, whether it's a holiday, whether it's something big in the news, or ultimately anything that Mr. Beast does. And at the end of the day, you know, if you're a content creator that are riding the trends and you're getting more views, well, you'll actually have ebbs and flows in that trend because there's gonna be more interest at certain times. When that interest is peaked, there is a decline. And when you see the decline of that interest, well, there goes the views. Now, let me give you a little tip here. And this is something that I want all content creators to do, is you need to go into your analytics and you need to be able to look at those trends. And you can be able to see that. Now, what I like to do is go into the advanced mode and really look at how the views go year over year, and you can start to define your trends. You can compare it to other year over year trends and where you're at, and you can almost anticipate when you're gonna be on an ebb or a flow. And number 2, you have a low CTR. What did that CTR is click-through rate. And basically what how YouTube is when you upload a video and you release it, it goes to browse feature, which is homepage or subscription feed. Basically, it's looking for some indicators of how many people see it that actually click on it. So if it's a really low percentage and they don't click on it, YouTube is not gonna suggest it out for more people. So you will lose those impressions that are super, super valuable. Also, one thing to look at this with CTR is realizing when people are watching your video, if the video that they're seeing either on the side, on desktop, or down below the video could be your video. And if it's a really bad title and thumbnail, it doesn't really engage, the CTR is gonna be low. Well, guess what? They're gonna skim right over that. And that's where YouTube's gonna see that signal and say, hey, they're not necessarily gonna be a good video. So let's not give it more impressions. Now, number 3, this is a big one. And it's basically saying that when somebody clicked on the video, they didn't want to finish the video. You have a very low average view duration or average percent viewed. And when that's low, ultimately you're not going to see a lot of momentum, because basically what happens is when you have a really good average view duration video, YouTube's going to serve it out more. When it serves it out more, videos pop up on the side that are suggesting your videos, and people will want to click that. And then basically you have this momentum going. So if you have one video that's really, really taking off, or if you're Mr. Beast, you have every video that's really, really taking off. What does YouTube have to do? It actually has to suggest those videos because they found the right viewer. And so if your video is underperforming, it's never gonna be suggested out there. And that is something that you need to look at. Now, a tip here, there's several ways that you could actually improve that. And one of the ones that you can improve it is really looking and analyzing how your video is performing and see these drop-off moments. You might see peaks here and you might see valleys there. What you need to do is analyze and improve the way that you actually do the edit. Now, one of the most powerful ways to improve is by using B-roll. And I love B-roll. I use it all the time. And in fact, Storyblocks is sponsoring this video. I love them to death. And really, to improve your video content, what I like to do is use Storyblocks. And you've seen in this video that I've used some clips and stuff like that, is you can search that library, find the right clip, and you get unlimited royalty-free downloads with each subscription plan to really spice up that video. Aw, yeah. Using Storyblocks, it helps me create more content because I don't have to go out and get that right perfect shot. Gets me excited, and that's why I love them. So go ahead and head over to Storyblocks. You'll find a link below in the description. tell them that Daryl sent you. Now, besides B-roll and using story blocks, what I like to do is really analyzing how my videos are performing and start seeing, hey, these videos are underperform. I like to put them in a group and start really deep diving and digesting it to see, oh, my video is underperforming here, and I start seeing patterns. I like to see patterns. Patterns is the correct answer. And when you see things drop, you're like, oh, here's a pattern of why they were doing that. You try to analyze what's going on. And then ultimately when things start to take off, I look at patterns of what's going on. And that comes into my brain, ding, ding, ding. And I wanna put that in another video so I can put it in the edit or ultimately improve my content moving forward. And number four, a lot of content creators like to test new content, or their audience shifted in what they actually like. And I can tell you, I've seen a lot of content creators that keep on putting the same type of videos over and over again. And guess what, guys? It gets exhausting. Not only for the creator, but for the viewer. When that happens, or when they want to test out new content and it's really disengaged, but they don't really look at their analytics, and so they have no idea. They just see the views going down and they blame YouTube. So a tip for that is surround yourself by like-minded creators, and these creators need to be kind of in the same vein, the same niche. Get feedback from them to see if, hey, this is a good idea or if it's not, because these mastermind groups, these feedback groups are really powerful. That's why I do several a week, because it's super powerful of really helping you navigate your video content and really understand YouTube a little bit better. And number five, a shift in traffic and traffic sources. We talked about viewer behavior and trending and so on and so forth. Well, let's kind of break it down from here. YouTube actually has traffic sources, and each traffic source has its own little algorithm, and it basically features your videos and people watch those videos and you see some traffic. So normally when you release a video, you see browse feature, which is subscription and homepage. You know, after 48 hours or so, it starts to go into suggested videos that goes across all of YouTube. Now, the thing about it is I've also seen a lot of channels that they get a certain type of traffic source. It could be search, it could be suggestion, it could be browse feature, and they get used to that happening. Today, something shifts, whether it's the content's not really resonating with that type of traffic source, and then YouTube's gonna put it in another area. And guess what, guys? At the end of the day, sometimes you will see a huge dip in views. This is probably one of the most common that I see with people that seem to get a lot of video views. They don't really know where their traffic's coming from, and there is a discrepancy in what they think is happening. And so they blame YouTube when ultimately it is a shift, but it's a shift in the viewing pattern and the behavior of the viewers, which takes us back to number one, which is seasonal trends and so on and so forth. Now, here is your power tip. I can tell you, I have seen this trend over and over and over again. And what I want you to do is don't focus in on trending, focus in on your own videos, make them better. Make them so that people want to click it. And not only when they want to click it, they want to finish it. And the higher percentages that you get will give you more impressions. The more impressions will get you more views will get you more subscribers. And guess what, guys? That is the secret. And I can tell you that a lot of you really need to optimize your videos so they can actually get more views and really understand that traffic source. That's why I made videos right here that teaches you how to optimize the video. So go watch that video, and we'll see you on the next video.